Peter and the Wolf, a musical tale for children. The characters are the bird, the duck, the cat, the grandfather, the wolf. The hunter's shots. Peter. Early one morning, young Peter opened the garden gate and went out into the big green meadow. High up in a tree sat a little bird, one of Peter's friends. "Everything is quiet and still," the bird chirped merrily. Following behind Peter and waddling from side to side came a duck. She was very glad that Peter hadn't shut the garden gate, and she decided to take a bath in the deep pond in the meadow. Thank you. When he saw the duck, the little bird flew down on the grass, sat beside the duck, and began to shrug his shoulders. "What sort of bird are you when you can't fly?" he said. "And what sort of bird are you," the duck retorted, "when you can't even swim?" And she flopped into the pond. They argued for a long time while the duck swam around the pond and the little bird hopped along the bank. Then Peter had a sudden fright. Creeping stealthily towards them through the grass came a cat. The cat was thinking, "So the bird is busy with his quarrel. I'll soon catch him." And without a sound on velvet paws, she crept up towards him. "Watch out!" shouted Peter, and in a flash the little bird flew up into a tree. Then the duck from the middle of the pond squawked angrily at the cat. The cat walked round and round the tree, thinking, "Would it be worth climbing that high? Now, by the time I get there, the bird will surely have flown away." Out came Peter's grandfather. He was angry with Peter for going out of the Golden Gate. "It's dangerous out here. What would happen if a wolf came out of the woods? What then?" Peter did not pay much attention to his grandfather's words. He explained that boys like him were not afraid of wolves. But his grandfather took Peter by the hand, led him home, and firmly locked the door behind them. And indeed, no sooner had Peter gone than out of the woods came an enormous gray wolf. Shot up into the tree. The duck squawked and flapped quickly out of the pond. But, flap as she might, the wolf was faster. He got closer and closer. He caught up with her. Seized her and swallowed her up. This was now the situation. The cat was perched on one branch. And the little bird on another. Little away from the cat. And the wolf was pacing around the tree, looking up at them with greedy eyes. Meanwhile, Peter had been standing behind the locked gate and had seen all that had happened without being at all afraid. He ran into the house, seized a thick rope, and climbed up to the top of the high garden wall. One of the branches of the tree, around which the wolf was still pacing, reached as far as the wall. So, catching hold of it, Peter sprang over into the tree. He said to the little bird, "Fly down and circle around the wolf's muzzle, but be careful he doesn't snap you up." Almost brushed the wolf's muzzle with his wings, and the wolf sprang angrily at him, this way and that. How that little bird teased the wolf, and how the wolf longed to catch hold of him. But the little bird was cunning, and the wolf just couldn't catch him. By now, Peter had made a noose with his rope, and very carefully he lowered it down. He slipped the noose over the wolf's tail and pulled it tight. Wolf, realizing he had been caught, began to leap about in fury, trying to tear himself free. Tied the other end of the rope to the tree. And the leaps of the wolf only drew the noose tighter around his tail. Just then, out of the woods came some hunters. They were following the trail of the wolf and firing their guns. But Peter shouted down from the tree, "You don't need to shoot! The little bird and I have already caught the wolf! Help us take him off to the zoo!" Now see the triumphant procession. Out in front marched Peter. After him, the hunters, leading the wolf. Behind them came Peter's grandfather with the cat. The grandfather was shaking his head unhappily. Well, well, but what if Peter hadn't caught the wolf? What then? Above their heads flew the little bird, chirping merrily. "See how clever we are, Peter and I. See what we have caught." If you listened carefully, you could hear the duck still quacking inside the wolf, for the wolf had been in such a hurry that he had swallowed her alive.